In this video, we're continuing on with the visualizing data worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up where we left off, we're going to complete numbers 3 and 4, which state to draw a stem and leaf plot for each data set. Now, in order to set up a stem and leaf plot, we're going to need to draw something that resembles a t-table. However, as opposed to x and y values, we're going to have the stem and the leaf. Now the stem is usually that greatest placed value. So for example, in our first set of data, we have the tens place and the ones place. And because we only have two place values, the stem will be our tens place and the leaf will be our ones place. So what we need to do is we need to make a key so that if somebody is looking at our stem and leaf plot, they know that the tens is the stem and the ones is the leaf. So let's pick this first number, 32. So in our key, we'll say 3, draw that line, that dividing line between the stem and leaf, 2 in the ones place, so 3 in the tens place and 2 in the ones place, that's equal to 32. So now that we have the foundation and our key for our stem and leaf plot, let's start. And lucky enough for us, our ages are in order from least to greatest. So starting with 32, we'll have 3 in the stem and then 2 in the leaf. Next, we'll move on to 44. That will be 4 in the stem and then 4 in the leaf. And then 45 will be 4 in the stem, which we already have, but now 5 in the leaf. For 46, we already have 4 in the stem, but now we're going to have 6 in the leaf for 46. And note that for a stem and leaf plot, the numbers need to increase going left to right. So we start with 44, then go to 45, and then go to 46. Now moving on to our next data point, we have 51. So that's going to be a 5 in the stem and a 1 in the leaf. We also have 54, 55, 57, 58, and 59. So besides a 1 in the leaf, we'll need a 4 in the leaf. Then we'll need a 5 in the leaf, a 7 in the leaf, an 8 in the leaf, and then a 9 in the leaf. So 51, 54, 55, 57, 58, and 59. Now moving on to 60. That will be a 6 in the stem and a 0 in the leaf. Next to 63, that would be a 6 in the stem, which we already have, and a 3 in the leaf. Now, for age 64, that's a 6 in the stem and a 4 in the leaf. So we've now taken care of 60, 63, 64. Now we just need to do 70, 75, and 79. So with the 7 as the stem, that's going to be 0 in the leaf, 5 in the leaf, and 9 in the leaf. 70, 75, and 79. And that's how you do a stem and leaf plot. Let's move on to number 4. In number 4, setting up our stem and leaf plot, we'll start with our t-table, and then we'll make our key. Now, looking at these numbers, if we go all the way to the left placeholder, that's going to be the 100,000th place, and right next to that will be the 10,000th place. So we're going to need to round each of these numbers. However, for our key, if we were to have a 6 as the stem and a 1 as the leaf, that would be 610,000 because the stem represents the 100,000th place and the leaf represents the 10,000th place. And we're going to need to order these. So let's find our smallest number. That's going to be Richmond at 204,000. So for our stem and leaf plot, we'll put 2, and then in the leaf, 4 will round down, so our leaf will be 0 for 200,000 for Richmond. Looking at our next largest value, that will be Gilbert of 208,000, where that 8 will round up, making the 10,000th place a 1. So 210,000 for Gilbert, Therefore, with a stem of 2, we'll have a leaf of 1. The next greatest population is Irving of 216,290, where this 6 will round up so that 1 will become a 2. So we're rounding Irving to 220,000, so that will be a 2 in the leaf. Next, we have Scottsdale at 217,000, and 217 will round up to 220, so then we'll have another 2 in our leaf, making sure to record those multiples. So two cities have an approximate population of 220,000, so there will be 2 twos in the leaf with a stem of 2. And then next will be Stockton of 291,000, which this one we can round down because the 1 comes afterwards. So Stockton has an approximate population of 290,000, so a leaf of 9. Next in our stem will come 3 for values of 300,000. So looking at our chart, we have Santa Ana of 324,000, where this 4 will round down so that we're at 320,000, so a 2 in the leaf. And then we have Aurora at 325,000, which will round up to 330,000, so a 3 in the leaf. And there's no more 3s in the 100,000th place, therefore we can move on to 4 in our stem. And if you look, there are no 4s, so we record 4 in the stem, but we do not write anything in the leaf. So next we'll move on to 5. So looking at the 500,000s, we're going to have one value within 500,000, and that's Portland of 583,000, which rounds to 580. So that will be an 8 in the leaf. And then next, on to 6, which we have 601, 608, and 617. Washington, D.C.'s population of 601 will round down to 600,000, so that will be a 0 in the leaf. Seattle's population of 608 will round up to 610,000, so that will be a 1 in the leaf. And then Boston's population of 617,000 will round up to 620,000, so that will be a 2 in the leaf. So 0, 1, and 2 follow the stem of 6. And then for our stem of 7, we have Fort Worth of 741, Columbus of 787, and Austin of 790. Fort Worth has a population of 741,000, so that will round down in the leaf to 740,000. Columbus has a population of 787, which will round up to 790,000. And Austin has a population of 790,390, which will round down to 790,000. And lastly, for our stem of 8, there's only one value, and that's San Francisco, that has a population of 805,000, which rounds up to 810, so a 1 in the leaf. And that's our stem and leaf plot for large U.S. city populations. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask them below. And if you found this video helpful, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Continue on to the next video, where I'll complete numbers 5 and 6, drawing a box and whisker plot for each data set.